Krishna clearly says that in the future also the individuality of the Lord and others, as it is confirmed in the Upanishads, will continue eternally. This statement of Krishna is authoritative.
Yes, Upanishad says, Nitya Nityanam. Now, Nitya means eternal. And the Supreme Lord is the Supreme Eternal. And we, individual souls, we are also many eternal. So he is the leader eternal. Eka bahunam, how he is leader? Eka bahunam vidadhati kaman. That one singular number eternal person, he is supplying all the needs of other eternal. These things are clearly said in the Veda. And actually, we are experiencing, just like in Christian theology, the individual goes to the church and prays God, give us our daily bread. Why? He is asking God. Of course, this atheist class of men are now teaching them, where is bread you are going to church? You come to us, we shall supply you bread. So, this Vedic thought is there also. The Veda says, Eka bahunam vidadati kama. That Supreme One, Eternal, is supplying, is maintaining all other individuals, Eternal. And Bible also enjoins that you go ask for your bread to God. Unless God is maintainer and supplier, why this injunction is there? Therefore, he is the leader, he is the maintainer. And the Veda clearly says, this is the position, he is the supreme. And by knowing this, one can become in peace. That is the Vedic injunction.
The statement of Krishna is authoritative because Krishna cannot be subject to illusion. If individuality...
Yes. If the Mahabhati philosopher says that this statement of Krishna is in Maya, that he says that everyone was individual in the past. No, in the past everyone was one, lump sum, homogeneous. And by Maya, we have become individual. If the Mahabhati says like that, then Krishna becomes one of the conditioned soul. He does not, he loses his authority. Because conditioned soul cannot give you the truth. I am conditioned soul, I cannot say something which is absolute. So Krishna is accepted as the absolute. So if the Mayavadi theory is accepted, then Krishna's theory has to be rejected. If Krishna is rejected, then there is no need of reading Krishna's book, Bhagavad Gita. It is useless, waste of time. He is a conditioned soul like us. Because we cannot take any instruction from a conditioned soul. The spiritual master, even if you take that he is conditioned soul, but he does not speak anything from his own side. He speaks from Krishna's side. So, unless the Vedic principle is that unless one is not liberated from the material condition, he cannot give us any perfect knowledge. The conditioned soul, however he may be, academically advanced, educated, he cannot give us any perfect knowledge. Only one who is above the condition of this material laws, he can give us the perfect knowledge. Similarly, Shankaracharya, he is also impersonalist, but he accepts Krishna, the supreme authority. So Bhagavan, Swayam Krishna, Krishna is that supreme personality of Godhead. The modern Mayavadi philosophers, they do not disclose this statement of Shankaracharya to cheat people. But Shankaracharya's statement is there, we can give evidence. He accepts Krishna as the supreme authority. He has written so many nice poems praising or worshipping Krishna. And at the last time, he says, Bhajagovindam, 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 Mudomate, you rascal fools. You have, depending on grammar to understand, this is all nonsense. Bhajagovindam, just worship Govindam. Bhajagovindam, Bhajagovindam, 3 times he says. Just worship Govindam. Bhajagovindam, Bhajagovindam, Bhajagovindam. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says 3 times, Harir Nama, Harir Nama, Harir Nama. 3 times means giving too much stress. Just like we sometimes say, do this, do this, do this. That means Namardina. Finish. All stress. So as soon as one thing is 3 times stress, that means final. So Shankaracharya says, Bhajagovindam, 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 Murahamate. Murah, 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 I several times explained, Murah means rascal, ass. You are depending on your grammatical understanding. Do king karane. Do king. These are grammatical affix and prefix. Pratta, prakaran. So you are depending on this verbal root, that verbal root, and creating, interpreting your meaning in a different way, all this nothing is nonsense. This duking karanane, your grammatical jugglery of words will not save you at the time of death. You rascal, you just worship Govinda, Govinda, Govinda. That is the instruction of Shankaracharya. Because he was a devotee, he was a great devotee. But he pretended to be an atheist because he was to deal with the atheist. Unless he presents himself as an atheist, the atheist followers will not hear him. Therefore, he presented Mayavad philosophy for the time being. The Mayavad philosophy cannot be accepted eternally. The eternal philosophy is Bhagavad Gita. That is the body.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.